Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now for the thousands joining us live and the millions joining us around the world, welcome back to the action. Welcome back to the incredible city of Cologne. It's time to meet the players. This is the German Darts Masters. Ladies and gentlemen, from Germany, making his televised debut, please welcome Christian
Tours as well, so he does have some stage experience.
Yeah, most of these players here tonight have played on the European Tour at some point, so they're used to the big crowds, and obviously a little bit of pressure on him in front of the partisan crowd over in Germany, but as we saw with the last one, he looks like he's enjoying it and looking forward to it at the same time.
Yeah, Bunse are ranked 120 in the world against Daryl Gurney. Ranked number 4 in the German Super League is Bunse, and we'll be getting Daryl on the stage very shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Northern Ireland, the former World Grand Prix champion and the winner of the Players' Championship Finals, ladies and gentlemen, it's Super G!
The German Darts Masters on the World Series certainly has not let us down here in Cologne. Everyone's still drawing their collective breath after that amazing performance from Virtual Unknown, but not so now. Nico Kurtz beating Gary Anderson 6-4 in arguably the biggest upset that we've seen in the 6 years of the World Series. Christian Bunse will have watched that with a keen eye, so will Daryl Gurney. He won't want to be on the end of another shock here Friday night in Germany. Gurney, who has reached one World Series final, but since he did that in America a couple of years ago, not had too much success on the World Series. Bunse has been in really good form on the development tour. Proof once again that the PDC is bringing through the talent to the very top. Let's see what the young man can do here. Certainly the biggest match that he will ever play so far on the biggest stage that he's ever played on. First to six to play James Wade in the quarterfinals.
Well, if Nico Kurtz can do it, why not Christian Bunse, who has been one of the leading lights on the development tour over the last year or so. Three times he's made a final on the youth tour, and that is not to be sniffed at when you see some of the talent on the development tour. For example, this tournament last year, we saw a guy whose greatest successes have been all on the youth system, the development tour system. He went on and reached the final of the tournament. Dimitri Vandenberg, only beaten by Mensur Suljovic, having taken out the likes of Gary Anderson along the way. So why not Christian Bunse?
85.
Yeah, good player. 24-year-old from Paderborn. But he's doing it tough. First year on the tour for the young German.
140.
Won a prize tour card the European qualifiers back in January. But it's been a tough baptism, certainly as far as competing with the top players on the Pro Tour has been. His success has come on the Development Tour. And I guess it's all about
58.
The progress as far as the German is concerned, but certainly I reckon there's a big future ahead for young Christian Bunse. Let's see if he can
25.
Cause another upset and knock Gurney out and send Gurney home as Gary Anderson is possibly already looking at flights.
125, this is 94.
Another chance here, and he's got options. He elects to go for the bullseye but misses it. It's the 17. A treble 19 for double 10. Not going to happen.
54.
So an early break for the world number four would certainly settle him down. Double 18. Great start from Daryl Gurney. 14 dart leg.
Second leg is Daryl through the first.
Bunse on a finish. That's what Gurney can do. Double major winner, of course, now in the rank to the PDC. Will go to the World Match Play next weekend at Blackpool as the number three seed, having just overtaken Gary Anderson. The aforementioned Gary Anderson in the world rankings.
Yeah, didn't play in this last year, Daryl Gurney, but he did play a couple of years ago, and he started that off with a whitewash, beat Mike Langendorf 6-0. Then went out to Phil the Power Taylor.
Who?
100.
Read a history book.
Okay. I'll look him up later.
Yeah, I think there's stuff on the internet about him.
96.
But Gurney, that's very much as he was becoming one of the top players in the world. And he's firmly there at the moment and going absolutely nowhere in many ways. The future of darts, even though a certain Mr. Taylor might have disagreed with that a way back.
Playing well, Gurney. All right, we're only in leg two, averaging 106, but Bunse already touching that 100 mark.
140.
They have played once before, and it's only 3 weeks ago on the tour. As you say, Christian got on the tour, his chance to play against the top players. That's what he wants to do. That's how you get better. You play the best in the world on a weekly basis.
58.
4-1 down and was only beaten 6-4, so he gave him a good test. But Gurney, on the big stage, is often where he does his best work. And
he
that's not back.
The second leg. Daryl Gurney. Third leg is Christian to throw first. Game one.
Yeah, big step up, but his compatriot Nico Kurtz managed it. Really has. Given the whole night a big lift.
100.
I'm sure Gary Anderson won't agree, but I think he missed 10 darts at double. Anderson missed a stack full of chances, but the young kid won on merit without a shadow of a doubt. We'll look forward to seeing him on Saturday night here in Cologne. You can see the Peter Wright or Robert Marjanovic. Gurney doing a job at the moment.
140.
And one of the things missing from Bunse's CV, and he's not been playing very long, is a big stage win. He's played on the European Tour, but he's not managed to win a game on there.
60.
So he doesn't have a great deal more experience than young Nico Kurtz, who preceded him. But we have seen enough from him on the tour to suggest that he can be dangerous. He's picked up some scalps. He's hitting 180s at a comparable frequency to somebody like James Wade on the tour. It's often about the first dart for Christian Bunse. If he gets it in the right place, he can follow it pretty reliably.
Of course, when you win a tour card, it then requires a massive commitment, doesn't it? especially for the European players who
100. That'll require 100.
Are travelling every weekend, and once you've played and travel days, you're looking at 5 days for a single weekend of darts.
58. Christian Yuripar, 55.
So a chance here to get a leg on the board. First dart at a double.
Only the one. Christian Bunse. Four wickets held in the first. Game one.
Daryl Gurney looking to complete the set this weekend. He's won on the Pro Tour, he's won a Euro Tour, his first Euro Tour title came this year. He of course has two massive TV titles under his belt already in the World Grand Prix and the Players Championship Finals. So a World Series title
99
would give him a lot. James Wade awaits the winner of this one after Wade's pretty comfortable 6-2 victory over Kevin Munch.
Too much wrong with the throw. Straight down the line from the young German. Not too much wrong with this either.
Big 180 hitter, Daryl Gurney, that's his first. And when he starts hitting them, he tends to go on little runs of hitting on every single leg, three or four legs. It becomes very, very difficult to live with Gurney scoring. They're singing that Phil Taylor's name. So, yeah, there you go. He does exist. I've not made him up. Let's do it.
That's a lever
finish. Double 16 for Gurney. Well done. 104. A 118 in the mix. A 3-1 lead.
Game on.
You Barney fans in, you will see Raymond van Barneveld's first appearance on the World Series tonight of 2019, that is, of course, taking on Gabriel Clemens in what the bookies reckon was the most likely place we'll see a shot tonight. We've already seen one in Gary Anderson being dumped out by the superb Nico Kurz.
Possibly was the least likely.
Quite possibly so.
With the bookmakers for an upset. Certainly got the potential. We've seen a glimpse 100. Of it here. Christian Bunse.
Now the first starts where he wants it. He's close for the second, and the third is there. That's what you will see. If he gets that first dart in the right place, the game becomes so much easier, but particularly so for Christian Bunse, it seems.
44, Christian Ripper, 89.
The Bunsen burner, as he's known. Bit chilly there. Look at the 20 segment or the treble 16, I would think.
41. 135.
A bit of pressure on Bunse here. Is it 16 or 16 or is it 8 for tops? He went for tops last time. I think he was actually aiming for 8 again there to leave tops.
32. That'll require 81.
In fact, I'm sure he was. So two missed darts and a double. This would be a pinch me leg for Gurney.
51, Christian Require 16.
Try again.
Panic.
Eight.
Yeah, five missed darts at double. There's the inexperience.
15 for Gurney. Made to look very, very simple. And he goes 4-1 up, just as he did when these two played on the Pro Tour a few weeks ago. Bunse got it back and made a game of it. But can he do it on a big stage in probably the biggest game of his career?
Yeah, without a doubt.
140.
Five missed darts at double, and it looks like plain sailing for Gurney on this opening night in Germany. Of course, next month the World Series moves down under to Brisbane, to Melbourne, and then a new venue in Hamilton in New Zealand, all building up to those World Series finals in Amsterdam 57. In the autumn. New venues being looked at for 2020 on the World Series.
95.
Spread the gospel even further and even wider.
140.
I suspect we may be experiencing darts in different cities around the globe next year.
Daniel Gurney absolutely racing through that last visit. Christian Bunse methodically registering his first max. Ron Harrington did say before this game started he felt that Gurney was more effective when he sped up a little bit. Oh, that's a long way off. So treble 14. Well, he should have at least have been getting a dart at the bullseye there, Christian Bunse, and Gurney has already taken this out. If he takes it out again, this game could be over very, very quickly. Double 16.
72.
The young German wasn't even looking. They will have caught a glimpse of him behind Gurney, just pouring out another glass of water. The crowd will have told him. And now back at tops.
Break
back for two.
Some of the German fans, some of the many German fans who've made it to Ali Pali in the World Championship. It's just a sign of the growth of the game in this part of the world.
Yeah. Tickets going on sale very soon, aren't they, for the World Championship? It starts on December the 13th at the Alexandra Palace.
I think you'll probably find about a quarter of them will go to German fans.
Yeah,
astonishing numbers the fans from this country had over there to see stars like Daryl Gurney doing stuff like that.
$135.
Done all right, Bunse.
96.
Gonna need another treble, you feel.
83.
Does not get it.
102.
A long way off, treble 14 or bull. Well, he's gone the bull route. Not sure it's the wisest one 62. In this situation. Treble 14, a bigger target. Would have given him a dart for the leg, but can Christian Bunse punish him?
Double 20 to lead the ball. So here we go. To reduce the gap to one.
105.
Unlucky.
W-40.
Now Gurney to go within one leg of the win.
Game shot on the
fine,
leg.
Fine margins Gurney. From Gurney. Going 5-2 up there, or finding himself pegged back to 4-3. The difference just a couple of millimetres.
$91.
There you see Gurney, efficient, lethal.
96.
Bunse, 7 missed darts at double. That one at bullseye, those 5 in the fifth leg. Couple of legs swing, and I tell you what, this game, oh, it could have been back-to-back shocks here in Cologne. Does not look likely now.
134.
Seen enough of Bunse to think that we'll be seeing a lot more of him in the years to come.
180
to take him to the verge of victory.
Oh, another one there. Superb stuff from Christian Bunse. Leaves himself a 2-dart checkout. Is it enough pressure? It is.
90.
Well, the 171, he deserves a shot. Got to get it, you feel, to stay in the contest. Tops, maybe. Oh, and another. Unlucky. Been unlucky throughout, you have to say, the young man. He's played really, really well, Bunse. But is that the last dart he throws? Indeed, it is. Daryl Gurney. Completes a 6-2 victory over young Christian Bunse. I think fair to say that the scoreline doesn't really reflect how good the young German was there. But the experience and class of Daryl Gurney showing in the end. It's Gurney who'll go through in Cologne to a quarter-final clash with James Wade.
Daryl Gurney is safely through to tomorrow night's quarterfinals of the World Series of Darts tournament in Cologne. 6-2 victor over the local boy, Christian Bunse. Those are the stats. 97 average for Daryl, 3 180s for him, 60% on the doubles, and he's through to meet James Wade tomorrow night. Hi, Chris Mason, Alan Warren a little. I've been watching that performance. Yes. Thoughts on Daryl?
Well, he did the job, really.
Daryl, congratulations. A professional display there.
Yeah, it was all right. I know he's a good player. I played him before on the Pro Tour, and I was absolutely on fire the day I played him. And I still only beat him 6-4, so I knew what to expect. So I knew if I got him the Elite, I wasn't going to let him come back at me. But he was a solid performer there. Obviously, I think that's his first time on TV. So fair dues to him. He played well, made a good account of himself. But I think he's one for the future.
When you look at last year, we had a different winner in every single event, and then Nathan Aspinall winning here. You're probably thinking, it's about time I got one of these under my belt.
Definitely. I mean, obviously, last week I'm thinking, well, it's either going to be me or Nathan wins it. And obviously, Nathan went and done it. If I got past Peter that day, I don't know, I could have been hardly stick, but Peter went and done a job on me after the break, so fair play to him. But hopefully I can win this one.
Good luck tomorrow.
Cheers, thank you.